Ah, the Nintendo Wii, a game console that sold millions of units, and it's actually Nintendo's second best-selling console to this day. Or fourth if you include DS and Game Boy systems. And some people still own their Wiis to this day, including me. But what some Wii owners don't know is that there's a lot more to the Wii than just games. It had a photo channel, a shop channel, news and forecast channels, and a lot of Wii owners just use them as streaming boxes, kind of like what we use nowadays, such as PlayStations, Xboxes, you get what I mean. But there is just one thing that very few Wii owners knew about, and that was homebrew. And eventually, homebrew led on to other Nintendo systems, such as the 3DS and Wii U systems, and even the Switch temporarily. But we'll talk about that another time. Today I'm going to show you how you can homebrew your Wii, as well as the virtual Wii on your Wii U. So, without further ado, let's get started. But, before we do, if you want to just get to the virtual Wii on Wii U, time mark is right here. But if you're doing an original Wii, let's just continue. Now, before we start, there's something that we'll need from our Wii first. If you go into Wii Options, and then Wii Settings, go to Internet, and then console information, this is what you'll need. You'll need your console's MAC address, which mine is going to be different from yours, and also blurred in post-production. So be sure you write yours down, just in case. Actually, not just in case, we're going to be needing it later. So once you have your console's MAC address, go to this website, please.hackme.com, and this is where we'll be using the letter bomb exploit. So anyway, system menu version. I'm picking 4.3U since I have a North American console. If you have a European console, a UK console, or an Australian console, you can pick 4.3E. If you have a Japanese console, you can pick 4.3J. If you have a console from Korea, I guess, just 4.3K. So once you have everything ready, just put in your console's MAC address. And once you're ready, click I am not a robot, and then it doesn't matter which wire cut, I'm clicking it. Now you can just save that file to your computer. Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to mention is that you'll need an SD card for both Wii and Wii U, so keep that in mind. So anyway, plug your SD card into your computer, open the zip file, go to your SD card, and then drag and drop all the files to the root of your SD card. Oh crap, hang on. Let's try that again, shall we? Okay, it's working now. Alright, so once everything's ready, you can now eject your SD card from your computer, put it in your Wii, and turn your Wii on. Anyway, let's start it. Next, you'll have to go to Wii Message Board. You will have to either... Oh! That was fast. Anyway, click the letter bomb, and it should install soon enough. Actually, take you to the Homebrew Channel Installer. Shouldn't take long. Once you are on the screen, you might have to wait a minute. Okay, that was perfect timing. Anyway, press 1 on your Wii remote. Click continue. Install a homebrew channel. Continue. Installing the homebrew channel. Success! Continue. Now exit. And once you exit, you should return to the... Oh, we're in the homebrew channel now. Interesting. And, there you go. You can now launch homebrew applications. There you go. Got the homebrew channel on your Wii now. Alright, let's do Wii U now. Alright, so before we do this on Wii U, I should mention that I have everything that I need to do this on this SD card. I'll have a link in the description to a zip file containing everything on this SD card, so let's give it a shot. Alright, so once your Wii U is booted up, you'll have to go into
Internet
browser, like I just did. Then once you're ready, you'll have to go out of this website through the Wii U browser, http://wiiuexploit.xyz/firmware/55x. Assuming that your console is on the latest firmware. And once you're ready, just click run exploit, let it do its thing. This shouldn't take too long. And I think my Wii U froze up. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, so that didn't work the first time, so let's give it another try. See if it works this time. Just give it a minute, let it do its thing. And it's doing it. It's going to the homebrew channel, launcher, I mean. Any second now. Alright, there we go. So now that it's done, you can go into WAPAX and then load. Press the A button. Just give it a minute and do it. Let it do its thing. And there we go. Successfully injected WAPAX. Alright, so once we're back on the Wii U menu, we can now go to the Wii menu. I'll pick TV. Since I don't really need the gamepad anymore. Of course, I will need it again to restore the Wii channel, which we will get to soon. Alright, so now that we're on the virtual Wii menu, let's go to the Mii channel. Start. Fat and Knit. Copying booter, launching booter. I think it's working. This software must not be sold, neither alone nor as part of a bundle. If you pay for this software or receive it as a part of a bundle following payment, you have been scammed and you demand your money back. Okay then. We've already been on the screen before. Wait just a few minutes. Well, maybe not. But maybe like 30 seconds or so. It should say press 1 to continue. Using iOS versions and sort of blah, 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 blah. Anyway, continue. Install the homebrew channel. Yes. Installing the homebrew channel. Success. Continue. Exit. Let's see if it works. Hey! Anyway, now I can go back to the system menu. And there it is, the homebrew channel. Alright, you might think that we're done here, but actually there's just one more thing we need to do. Go back to the Wii U menu. Oops, not that. Go back to the Wii U menu. Alright, so once you're back into the Wii U menu, you can go back into the web browser and then run the exploit once more. Hopefully it works this time. Once you're back into the homebrew launcher, I'll have to relaunch WAPAX. Open it. Now this time you'll have to press the B button. Okay guys, done. Wii channel restored. Yay! Alright, once we're back in the Wii menu, you can check to be sure if the Wii channel works again. Start. See if it works. Hey! I forgot. Wii channel works! Yay! Alright, so Wii channel works again. I'm just gonna turn on my Wii U now. So, what can you do with homebrew now that you've homebrewed your Wii and or Wii U? Virtual Wii? A lot of things, actually. There's a bunch of emulators for the Wii, including FCE Ultra DX, SNES 9X GX, VBA GX, and RetroArch. Of course, there's also Wii U RetroArch. So, if you'd rather do that, then by all means, go ahead. Also on Wii, there's a Nintendo 64 and PlayStation emulator that doesn't really work natively on Wii U, so it's a good thing that if you homebrewed your virtual Wii, it'll work just fine. Plus, there's some mods for certain games out there, like you can use CTGP for Mario Kart Wii, and even newer Super Mario Bros. Wii. I'm using a white case right now, but I'm hoping to make it a blue one soon. There's also this project called the Open Shop Channel, which basically allows you to download pretty much any homebrew application you want. And since Nintendo Wi-Fi connection was shut down on both Wii U and DS, you can actually restore this feature with Wii MMFI and also Reconnect 24, which is a replacement for Wii Connect 24 since it was also shut down. No. So I guess that does it for now. So anyway, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, comment, click the notification bell if you like. And if you have any questions about Homebrew, leave them down in the comments below. And that's all you gotta do. So goodbye. Quick tip, it's a good idea to have a LAN adapter for your Wii U.